A very good morning, my dear students. I am Venkat. Welcome to my Aniruddha tutorials. I started the very quick revision upon Jeevali subject for the NEET aspirants. You are going to write the NEET examination very shortly. So it's a very quick glance. I started structural organization. In my previous class, I completed the epithelium. In this class, I am going to discuss about the connective tissues. Connective tissues are generally mesodermal in origin. Mesodermal in origin. And one more. Connective tissues are generally vascular. Generally vascular. And there is one connective tissue in exceptional. There is one exceptional case in the vascularization of a connective tissue, and that exception case is the cartilage. Cartilage is non-vascular. Cartilage is non-vascular connective tissue. So, what is a connective tissue? Connective tissue should contain the cells and fibers along with the extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix. The extracellular matrix of the connective tissue contain mainly water, polysaccharides, and also the proteins. This is the biochemistry of the extracellular matrix. There are different types of the cells are present and fibers. Generally, there are three types of the fibers are present in a connective tissue. There are maybe collagen fibers. Second one are the elastin fibers. And third one the reticular fibers. Collagen, elastin, and reticular fibers. This is the composition of a connective tissue. Connective tissue means cells, fibers, and the extracellular matrix. Matrix chemical composition is water and polysaccharides and the proteins. And very fastly, I am going to discuss about the types of the connective tissues. There are loose connective tissues, dense connective tissues, and the specialized connective tissues. Therefore, I should write a very important point here. There are some specialized connective tissues. Please notice that specialized connective tissues are, this is very important bit, one is the cartilage. Cartilage is a specialized connective tissue. Second one, the bone, and one more is the blood. These are the three specialized connective tissues. And before I start the connective tissues, and these are very, very important points to remember. And there are some structure, some connective tissues which are forming the structural framework. Therefore, the structural framework to the epithelium. The connective tissue which forms the structural framework to the epithelium is the areolar connective tissue. It is very important. Areolar connective tissue forms the structural framework to the epithelium. Next one, the tissue which is forming the structural framework to the body. Therefore, I write here the structural framework to the body is the bone. This is important. And one more, you should have been confused that there is a connective tissue which is specialized for storage of the fat, but this is not a specialized connective tissue. Adipose connective tissue is specialized for fat storage. Adipose is a specialized for fat storage, but it is not coming under the specialized connective tissues. I repeat again, there are some specialized connective tissues in the human body. One is the cartilage, bone and the blood. There are some connective tissues which are forming the structural framework. There is a structural framework to the epithelium in the areolar connective tissue. Structural framework to the body is the bone, and this is the adipose, which is specialized for the fat storage. And now these connective tissues are, first of all, the loose connective tissues. Loose connective tissues are as follows. One, the loose connective tissues. Loose connective tissues are basically two types. One is the areolar connective tissue. The important points to remember upon the areolar connective tissue is, one is, it is a typical connective tissue. Why it is a typical connective tissue? Because it contain all types of the cells. It contain all types of the cells and all types of the fibers. All types of the cells and all types of fibers are present. Hence, it is a typical connective tissue. And one more, the most widespread connective tissue. Most widely spread connective tissue in the body is the areolar. Here it is important point I have to remind you, what is the most widely spread tissue in the body? The most widely spread tissue in the body is the connective tissue. I write here, the most widely spread tissue in the entire body is the connective tissues. Connective tissues are widely spread tissues. In that connective tissue, most widely spread connective tissue is the areolar. As it is containing the all types of cells and all types of fibers, this is why called as the, it is a typical connective tissue. If you want to see the diagram of the areolar connective tissue, the diagram is as follows. Diagram of the areolar. Most of times, areolar connective tissue diagram is being asked, please. Here that this is a cell. And this cell name is the fibroblast. Fibroblast is cell. What is the purpose of the fibroblast? It forms fibers. Forming cells are called the fibroblast. I repeat again, fiber forming cells in the connective tissue are called as fibroblast. Okay, these are the fibers which are in the bundle. These fibers are called as the collagen fibers. Collagen fibers. Here I do want to tell you one thing. Collagen is the most widely Collagen is the most widely spread protein in the human body. The most abundant protein in the human body is the collagen. Collagen is a white protein. Collagen is a white protein. Collagens are arranged in the bundles. Collagen is the most abundant present protein in the body, and this is the cell which is formed. Fibers, not only collagen fibers. See, these are the collagen fibers which are arranged in the bundles. There are other types of the fibers are visible in the connective tissue, also in the areolar. And these are the fibers. And these fibers are called as the elastin fibers. These are the elastin fibers. Elastin fibers. Elastin also a protein, but protein is a yellow protein. Elastin is a yellow protein. Collagen is a white protein. I repeat again, the collagen is the most abundant protein in the human body. And there are some other fibers, and they are reticular fiber. As it is for the reticulum, a metallic structure, and these fibers are called the reticular fibers. Reticular fibers also made up of the collagen. But here, and these collagens are not arranged in the bundles, but in the form of a reticulum called reticular fibers. Therefore, there are three types of fibers: the collagen fibers, the elastin fibers, and the reticular fibers. And the other structural aspects of the area that we show. As I told you, connective tissue contains the six fibers, and this is the remaining extracellular matrix. And the matrix contains one polysaccharides and the proteins. As far as I have discussed one type of cell, and the type of the cells are the fibroblasts. Fibroblasts are the fiber forming cells. Right here, the fiber forming cells. The fiber forming cells are the fibroblasts. And the other cells, if you see this, there is a diagram on the bottom side. I have represented a cell. That cell is the mast cell. This is the mast cell. Mast cell in the area we show, this is some chemicals like the histamine, bradykinin, serotonin. Histamine bradykinins are the vasodilators. Also, histamine bradykinins are also called as the inflammatory chemicals. They cause inflammation. What is the meaning of the inflammation? Rubor, tumor, color, dollar. Rubor means redness. Tumor means swelling. Color means pain. Dollar means heat. That is talking about the inflammatory mediation, inflammatory reactions inside the body, and that inflammation is caused by the chemicals which are released from the mast are called as histamine and bradykinin. There are two functions of the histamine and bradykinin. One is the vasodilation, second one is the inflammation. This is all about the mast cell, and this is one type of the cell, and this is called as the macrophage. I present diagram. This cell is Macrophages are nothing but the phagocytic cells, nothing but the modification of monocytes. Monocytes, as long as they are present in the blood vessel, if the monocytes are migrating to the brain, they are called microglia cells. If they are present in the liver, they are called macrophages. If they are present in the connective tissue, they are called macrophages. If they are moving macrophages, they are called the wearing macrophages. If they are tissue fixed, they are the histiocytes. But it is always a monocytic population present in the various parts of the human body. And here also, macrophages are nothing but the phagocytic cells. And contain also the areolar, also contain the cells are called as the adipocytes. For example, this is one adipocyte. Adipocytes are modified. Adipocytes are specialized for the fat storage, and this is the fat storing area. This is the fat storing area, and remaining is it has a little bit of the cytoplasm with the nucleus. There is a extrinsic nucleus. This is the extrinsic nucleus. Extrinsic nucleus in the adipocyte, and this is the fat storing area. And coming to the other type of the cells also present in the areolar, and these cells are called as the plasma cells. What are the plasma cells? Plasma cells are nothing but a type of the B lymphocytic population. In the second lymphoid organs, the B lymphocytes are dividing. If the B lymphocytes are interacting with the antigen, I told you that in the many times I told you that in the second lymphoid organs, both the B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes are interacting with the antigen. In the primary lymphoid organs, both B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes are becoming into the antigen sensitive. In the secondary lymphoid organ, these two cells are interacting with the antigen. Upon interaction, there is a replication, there is a proliferation. Upon the proliferation, it gives the effector cells. One type of effector cells of the B lymphocytes are plasma cells, and one more are called the memory cells. Memory cells are long-lived. Plasma cells are releasing the antibody in the first encounter of the antigen. Okay.
These are as many as five types of the cells are present in the areolar. Therefore, areolar contain all five types of the cells. One, fibroblasts, macrophages and the mast cells and plasma cells, adipocytes. There are five different types of the cells are present in the areolar. Three different types of the fibers are present, both collagen, elastin, reticular fibers are present. That is why areolar is a typical connective tissue. Most widely spread connective tissue. I told you that in the human body, most abundant tissue is the connective tissue. Among the connective tissue, more abundant is the areolar connective tissue. Here itself, I don't want to tell you one more thing. These loose connective tissues are areolar. Second one is the adipose. Adipose connective tissue also a loose connective tissue. Adipose also a loose connective tissue. Second one, adipose connective tissue is specialized for fat storing. Adipose connective tissue working as a shock absorber. Adipose connective tissue working as a shock absorber. It works as a cushion to the soft organ. And adipose tissue is modified as the buffer. Buffer is nothing but adipose tissue in the marine mammals. Blubber in marine mammals like the whales, dolphins, etc. The adipose tissue is below the skin is the blubber. Therefore, adipose is specialized for the fat storing. It's a shock absorber. As a solution, the adipose is modified as a blubber in marine mammals. In this adipose tissue, you have to see the diagram. The diagram is as follows. This is the adipose cell adipocyte. This is the adipocyte and this is the plasma membrane. See that labeling also. This is one more adipocyte. It has a extrinsic nucleus. So, peripheral cytoplasm and the extrinsic nucleus. Very little cytoplasm is present. And this is the fat storing area. It's all about adipose. So that now I have completed the connective tissues are loose connective tissues. Second one are the disconnective tissues. What are the dense connective tissues? I go further. Dense connective tissue means when cells are very densely packed. Fibers and cells are very dense. Cells and fibers. Here I want to tell you, dense connective tissue fibers most iron. It is represented in a test tube. Fibers in the connective tissue are mostly collagen fibers. And the cells are very tightly packed. That is why called the dense connective tissue. See, dense connective tissues are of two types. One is called dense regular connective tissues. Second one are the dense irregular connective tissues. Diagram. See that diagram of the regular and also regular. The diagram is as follows. The collagen fibers are oriented in a specific direction. That is the regular orientation of the streamline orientation of the collagen fibers. These are collagen fibers are regularly oriented. Oriented, and these are the fibers.
blast cell. See the labeling also. These are the fibroblast cells. Fibroblast cells, collagen fibers with a diagram and regular ratio. Delicella. Examples of the delicella regular. One is a tendon. Second one is a ligament. Tendon is a property of only skeletal muscle. Tendon is property of only skeletal muscle. Therefore, tendon is connecting skeletal muscle to bone. Either skeleton is connecting the skeletal muscle to bone, and ligament is the connection between the bone to bone. Bone to bone connection is called as the ligament. Bone, tendon, ligament are some best examples of the dense regular connective tissue. Second one is irregular, where the collagen fibers are irregularly oriented. Irregularly oriented. That is why called as a dense irregular. And these are the collagen fibers, the irregular arrangement, irregular orientation of the collagen fibers, of the collagen fibers, and these are the fibroblast cells. See the diagram again. These are the fibroblasts, and these are the collagen fibers. That is why these are irregularly oriented, called as the irregular connective tissue. Examples of this irregular connective tissue are: one is pericardium, pericondrium, periosteum around the bone. Not only pericardium, pericondrium, periosteum, endosteum, deeper region of dermis and the articular capsule between the two regions or capsule, joint capsule. It's a joint capsule. Pericondrium, pericardium, periosteum, endosteum, deeper region of the dermis are lined by it, contain the connective tissue called the dense irregular connective tissue, where collagen fibers are irregularly arranged, and the fibroblasts also. This is all about the loose connective tissues and the dense connective tissues. And coming to the specialized connective tissues, are I need not explain about far more. See that textbook, dense loose connective tissues and the dense connective tissues. After that, specialized connective tissues. There are specialized connective tissues. One is the cartilage, bone, and also the blood. If you see the matter or material present in the textbook, I go faster again because your time is very precious. Specialized connective tissues. Specialized connective tissues. One is the cartilage, commonly called as the gristle. Okay, cartilage contain the lacuna. There is a fluid filled sinus is called as the lacuna. In the lacuna of the cartilage, it is a very important point. What is present inside the lacuna of the cartilage? Lacuna lodges the chondrocytes. Lacuna contain the chondrocytes in a cartilage. Cartilage is generally non-vascular. Okay, I told you. Cartilage is non-vascular or avascular. And one more is, cartilage matrix is pliable. Cartilage matrix is pliable. What is the reason for the pliability of the cartilage matrix? Because it contains the chondroitin salts. Chondroitin salts are present, that is why matrix of the cartilage is pliable. Okay, next one is the bone. Bone matrix is not pliable. Matrix of the bone is not pliable because bone contains the collagen fibers, also calcium salts.
Both calcium salts and collagen fibers are making bone very rigid. The ductile connective tissue of the body is the bone. Bone is the structural framework of the body. Bone is generally present, okay, for bones and hind limb bones. In the textbook I wrote that the hind limb bones are bearing the body weight. Hind limb bones are generally bearing the body weight. These are important points regarding bone and also cartilage. Okay, one more point is, inside the lacuna of the bone contains osteocyte is present in the lacuna. Chondrocyte, because in the cartilage, many 4 to 8 number of chondrocytes are present in one lacuna. In the bone, one lacuna, not just only one osteocyte. One is that, I tell anything, is the fluid. Red river, the life is the blood. It contains the plasma and also the formed element. Plasma equals to 50%, the formed element is 40%. And in this chapter, I have represented only some of the diagrams of blood cells. Okay, we will discuss the circulatory system and fluid connective circulatory system of human beings. So that I have completed about the specialized connective tissues in the cartilage and the blood. Thank you for watching this class. I hope you understand it. Thank you very much.